Welcome to the third episode of Amazing Leadership Style of Dr. Satish Mohr. Again, welcome to Ekbon Soch Ki T-Tot Train of Thought. In our earlier episode, we did spoke about Dr. Satish education qualification which was concerned. Then we did had a discussion in terms of as far as public sector experience which was concerned on the leadership role, and then equally when we went into his authorship, like when he started writing and all. So now, in fact, for last couple of years, we have been going through a crisis. There is a loss of jobs, there's a lot of stress level everywhere. People are confused, the jobs are not there, is work from home culture which is there. I myself have gone through your book, that's Discover the Arjuna in You, where there are the 18 steps as far as this book which goes. So can you throw a light on those 18 steps which are there as far as discovering Arjuna is concerned, and what came in your mind while scripting this book?
When I used to hear Swami Chinmayananda talk about Bhagavad Gita and its teachings, and after Chinmayananda was no more, I wanted to know more about Bhagavad Gita. I started reading various commentaries on Bhagavad Gita. You may be surprised to know that I read more than 30 commentaries of Bhagavad Gita written by any commentary which I could lay hand on. And one thing I found, that everyone has looked at Bhagavad Gita from their own perspective. Like when Tilak is writing on Bhagavad Gita, he is a revolutionary and thinking about the transforming the nation. So his book would contain something about that. When Vinoba Bhave is writing Gita Pravachane in Marathi, and when he is talking to his followers, his focus is transforming your own personality and for seva for the people. When you hear Swami Chinmayananda talking about it, he looks at 360 degree view of the Srishti, the world, and how we are part of it, how this Brahmand has come in, and how we can merge with the Brahma. So every person, he's a spiritual person, so he wanted to take us to our development process. So every commentator has written book based on their own perspective. Paramahansa Yogananda, his books, God Talks with Arjuna, he has taken Bhagavad Gita's interpretation to a very different level, and he is talking about this Kaurav and Pandav Yudha as a fight between good and evil, which exists within our own body, and how do we overcome that. So everyone has taken the teaching of Bhagavad Gita based on their own perspective and based on their own thought process. So when I started writing and thinking about Bhagavad Gita, and everywhere the common thing was Karma Yoga, that we should follow Karma Yoga. And you say that karma kiye ja phal ki chinta mat kar. I realized in my life I could never do that. And if somebody says that they can do it, I will take them as a sadhu, sant, sannyasi, or a god incarnation. Because all of us do karma because I am doing it and I want a result. So how is it possible that Krishna says that karma kiye ja, lekin phal ki chinta mat kar? So when I started going deep into Bhagavad Gita and started making notes, I came across this shloka in Bhagavad Gita which says that a person is a fool who thinks that he is doing the action. It is the Triguna which is making him do all this. And then when I started looking at Bhagavad Gita and I started looking at all the shlokas where the reference to Triguna was there, and it opened entirely a different concept of Bhagavad Gita. Right from second chapter to 18th chapter, Triguna comes nearly in every chapter. And Krishna all the time says that it is not you who is working, but it is the influence of Triguna which makes you act in a different manner. And I was surprised to see that from 13th chapter to 18th chapter, there is nothing but Triguna. So one third of the Bhagavad Gita is totally devoted to Triguna concept. And even in first 12th chapter, when he's talking about Karma Yoga and devotion, he's talking about this Triguna. So I did a lot of thinking. I would say I used to sit in meditation, in meditative stage. I used to think about why Krishna is talking about this Triguna and how it is important. And then it started clicking to me that a mobile is there, and when you remove the battery, that mobile is like a stone. But that the battery, once you put it, becomes a mobile, and whichever software you download, if it is Android system or iPhone system, it works accordingly. So I started thinking that this Triguna composition in our body is the energy which guides our body, which is made up of this Pancha Tattva. So which is the makeup of our body, and this Triguna energy is its combination drives us towards various desires. And based on those desires, how they force us towards in a particular direction, we make our career or we want to do something. So at that time, I came across a person who was doing MBTI test. MBTI test is very common for recruitment in Western societies. So I thought that if Krishna is doing this Triguna testing of Arjun, and finally at the in the last chapter Krishna is telling him that you are a warrior and your combination, your Triguna combination is such that even if you want to run away from this fight today, but eventually you will fight because that is your Swadharma. So we cannot run away from our Swadharma, and how to find out our Swadharma, this Triguna model can help us. So I think from 95-96 onwards, I started developing some models on Triguna, and various models I developed. By 2005, the whole thing was very clear in my mind how it should be done. I have seen 10-15 tests where people give a questionnaire and they say, okay, your Sattvic score is this, Rajasic score is this, Tamasic score is this, and you are a Sattvic person, a Rajasic person, or a Tamasic person. But in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that it is not only that this one particular guna is dominant, but also the combination of these gunas and these gunas together, which makes you what you are. And he also says that at some point of time, Sattvic guna is more dominant, at some point of time, Rajasic guna is more dominant, at some point of time, Tamasic guna is more dominant. So, and their combinations will also change based on your behavior will change, the way you deal with the world will change based on which guna is more dominant. So I started thinking that why can't I develop a tool which can give me the scores of Sattva, Rajas, Tamas and their combinations of a person, so that I can tell that person that when Sattva Guna is dominant, this is your personality. When Rajas is dominant, this is your personality. And this, when Tamas is dominant, this is your personality. And in the process, I worked with my wife, and in fact, she got PhD on this Triguna concept from Jabalpur University.
Ah, okay. Wow.
Yeah, human response in organization based on Bhagavad Gita's Rajasic, Sattvic, Tamasic concept.
Okay.
And we did more than 1200 surveys questionnaire of RSS volunteers, that why they want to work in RSS and why spending their own money and time they work for RSS. And we, in that PhD, my wife found that most of the RSS workers are dominantly Sattva Rajasic, that is, they want to do good for the society and they are willing to spend time and money to meet their goal. So I kept on working on that model, and nearly after 10-15 years I could make a model. So in 2008, when I was invited to America to give lectures in universities like San Diego and USC, so the person who had invited me told me just one thing, that Satish ji, when you come there, when you say somebody is tamasic and tamas is bad, which would not be acceptable to people because you cannot say that. I said, this is what exactly I am saying, that whether it is Sattva, Rajas or Tamas, everything is good, everything is required. So for more of the details, I will not go into that. You can go to my website satishmod.com and see the whole concepts there. I have published some very good research papers based on conflict management, based on this Triguna, in Sage Publications, in IIM Kolkata's New Journal of Human Values. So you can also see that. So I did lot of work and I wanted to test it based on the validity of this testing process, and I published some research papers. And then over a period of time, the tool became very, very strong. And on my website, more than 30,000 people have so far appeared in the test. So what Krishna did to Arjuna, I thought whether I can replicate in some modest way that particular test and help people to decide their career, because I still say that this Bhagavad Gita is a career guidance for Arjuna. So why can't we use this Triguna model for our career guidance? So this is one of the very, very important aspect of Bhagavad Gita, which we should not forget.
I think, again, amazing leadership, Dr. Satish Mohr. I think Discover Arjuna and You, the way beautifully came with a book, that's a best-selling book, which have got around 18 steps which are there. I'm sure, like, if you read this book, Discover the Arjuna and You, I think to a certain extent will lead to the right direction. And apart from that, I would tell my audience, like, just go and visit www.satishmohr.com on Triguna, which is there. There are the three tests which are being conducted. One is on leadership style report, one is a career guidance report, and one is an RST personality test, which is there, that report. And I'm sure, like, it's based on these three gunas. Like, you know, first of all, I think you should know about your personality. And I think just follow Dr. Satish Mohr's video, which are there on this, all these three gunas which are there, and with beautiful stories to connect to that. So I'll request my audience to just go and follow Dr. Satish Mohr. That's so. Thank you very much for being part of this wonderful session to what we had in part 3 as well.